Hello and welcome to the Server2Server course for Photon 3.0 brought to you by CJR Gaming. My name is Christian Richards and in this video we are going to cover the creation of the peer that listens for subservers coming in. So to begin with, go ahead and open up Visual Studio. We are going to add a new class, and that class I'm going to call IncomingSubServerPeer, so that we know that subservers are going to be connecting to our master server, not the other way around. This class will first need to inherit from the class ServerPeerBase. Now this class gives us the stuff we need in order to handle connections to other servers. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to create a public constructor for our incoming subserver peer, and in it I am going to expect to receive an init request and then a connection to our master server. And then the first thing that's going to need to happen is we need to call the server peer base's constructor. And to do that, we just call base, and we are going to pass in request, and then we need the protocol, and then we need to go for the request and get the photon peer. Now, once we have that in place, there's two things I want to set up before I get very far, and that is to create a private master server variable called server, so that we can set that right off the bat. And then the other thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and set up my private static read-only iLogger and call it log. And that's going to be set equal to the log manager.get current class logger. And then just so that we keep track of what's going on, I'm going to say if log.isDebug enabled, I'm going to come in here and I'm going to say log.debug format, and I'm going to pass in subserver connected from 0, 1, and then I'm also going to say server ID, and that is going to be 2. Now, because we have called our base constructor from the server peer, we can just grab a couple of really quick things here. For 0, we are going to go with the remote IP. For 1, we are going to go with the remote port. And for 2, we are going to go with the connection ID. And so that's just what connection we are talking to, as opposed to really the server ID. So let's just change that real quick so we know that we're dealing with a connection ID there. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and implement the members, and you'll see that we have peer base being implemented here, which gives us our on operation request and our on disconnect. Now that's just like any other server peer. You'll find that when you connect to using just a peer base for your Unity client, you'll see that we pull in requests, you can tell it whatever it needs to do on disconnect. But then beyond that, we also have the server peer base, and that gives us the two functions of on event and on operation response. And what that gives us access to is if this is a connection to another server, which is what it is being the server peer base, we can get from that server events or operation responses due to requests that we've sent to that server. And so those are those two important functions that we need. Now for now, I'm just going to leave on event and on operation request as the not implemented exception. The on operation request, I'm going to go ahead and just say if, and then if the debug is enabled, I am just going to log to the debugger, in debug format, I'm going to say received operation request from and then I'm also going to get the operation code. And so from that, we're just going to go ahead and get our connection ID for 0, and then for 1, we're going to get our our operation request, and I'm just going to return its op code. And so that'll be printed out in that log right there. And then here in the onDisconnect, I'm going to do the same thing as I did before. I'm going to say on log is debug enabled, and then I'm just going to do a log debug format, and I'm going to say connection from terminated, and that way we can again just pass in that connection ID. And so that's really everything we need in order to get our initial subserver peer set up. The only thing we have left to do is go into master server in the create peer function from within our check to see if it is one of our subservers, which this is erroneously named. So I'm just really quick going to change that to be is subserver peer. And then from within that, if it is one of our subservers, meaning if it did connect from that incoming subserver port, I am going to want to return a new incoming subserver peer, passing in the init request that we received, and then this, which is the master server. And so that's everything now. If we were to receive a connection from another server on the local port, it would go ahead and come into our incoming server and get it set up. The next video that we're going to cover is going to go into creating the operation that, handling the operation that we'll create later, which is what the subserver will send to the master server when it says, yes, I really am a valid server, I want to be registered and added to your list of subservers. Till then.